Welcome to Pottery Central. Tonight, we're going to do a continuation at my friend Carrie's special request to see more about the Japanese baskets.
And
you may want to go back into your subscribed, preferably, YouTube channel with Pottery Central and look up how we made this puppy. We're going to trim this and then I'm gonna do some carving on it, and then I'm gonna talk a little bit about how I'm gonna finish this basket. This is experimental, so I've never actually done this, but it's cool. You know, we'll see how it goes. So now I've got the pot trimmed to a thickness that I think is reasonable. But since I'm carving it, I don't necessarily have to get it, you know, as thin as I might normally. Just want the way proportionate. That's pretty good. So let me show you how I do this. These are a couple of the Kemper mini ribbon tools. They come in, I think, three different shapes and two different
so
sizes.
Whenever I'm going to carve something, unless it's like a huge like piece that I'm really intent to make some kind of mega artistic statement, then I usually will just kind of freehand it with the trim tool, the mini ribbon tool. Just depends on what you're trying to do. If I'm trying to get the likeness of something, you know, maybe I draw it out more. If I'm just doing a pattern. So like in this case, for some reason I'm seeing, some kind of even fish image. You know, so fish image is actually pretty easy. So let's go with a fish image. Another ain't no rest for the wicked until we close our eyes for good. Not even 15 minutes later, I'm still walking down the street when I saw the shadow of a man creep out of sight. And then he swept up from behind. He put a gun up to my head. He made it clear he wasn't looking for a fight. He said, kill me all you got. I want your money, not your life. If you try to make a move, I won't think twice. I told him you could have my cash, but first you know I gotta ask, what made you wanna live this kind of life? He said there ain't no rest for the wicked. Money don't grow on trees. I got bills to pay, I got mouths to feed. There ain't nothing in this world for free. I know I can't slow down, I can't hold back, though you know I wish I could. Oh no, there ain't no rest for the wicked until we close our eyes for good. This little wavy motion, and that wavy motion is gonna give a sense of movement and water. So you see, this is how I'm doing this. I'm putting that corner in there, and then you can't overthink this. You gotta roll with it and follow that other line and then pull it out. It's all right, you can do it. So you can do this pattern all the way across the entire surface, or you could do like a little here, maybe it only comes up to here, you know, then a long one here, you know, and then you fill in your fish here, you know, we'll do, you know, I'd do the same thing on the other side. So, you know, it's up to you, and it can be really tight. I mean, you could do geometric patterns if you wanted to and plot it all out.
We've done a little bit more carving on it, and you know, I could work on this and put a lot of details, you know, more details in it, and I will. But another thing I sometimes do is I'll go in and put porcelain slip in certain areas, or add raised areas even with a thicker slip. But you know, it's all up to you. There's a gazillion different techniques. And the more tools you have in your toolbox, the more variation in the surface of your pots, typically the more interesting they are, in my opinion. Sometimes less is more.
As we talked about in the previous video, you know, and this one's got the reed wrapped ends that hold it in place. I wanted to try something new today. I haven't tried this before, so hey.
I want to look at it from various angles so that I know where, you know, visually where it would be the most appealing. And I don't know. Equal looks pretty good to me. Guess it's not totally equal. I kind of like the flat side up.
I think I'm going to go with flat side up and have this little nodule, just a little askew, maybe. Oh. Good experiment. Thanks a lot for joining us for part two of Japanese baskets at Pottery Central. We wish we could.